All right. It is 6:40 a.m. on May the 20th.
May the 4th still be with you.
May the 4th be with you. Tell us what is happening. Why are we up this freaking early in the morning?
Well, being adults, we probably usually should be.
But we're the worst adults. Yeah.
We're not good at adulting. We are going to drive to Florida for Disney World and Universal again.
All right. We are calculating our route. This is the way that we're going to go.
Maybe. Now we're at 24. Okay, so about 24 hours with charging.
Not bad.
Yeah.
We're not going to do that, though. We are definitely stopping overnight. Yeah. It's road trip time!
Yay!
Woohoo!
So we're just doing our Toronto to Florida trip, take two. We're actually doing it now. It's summer. It's June-ish. So we did our last one in the winter, and we want to see how the battery varies. Now, of course, that was 4 months later, so maybe there's a bit of degradation, but we don't actually drive a lot in the city because we live right downtown and don't need to. But we're going to see. It looks like the battery just preliminary, how long we need to charge and how far we can go based off the calculations from the Tesla, that the battery will hold up a little longer than last time, but we'll know for sure as we drive and see what happens. And of course, we're gonna stick to the speed limit as usual. But yeah, stay along for the ride and we'll keep you posted as we go.
And I guess just as an FYI, both to us and to you, we are leaving and it is 7:07 a.m.
We've grown up this time.
we're still an hour later than when we intended to leave, but we did get out of the apartment much earlier this time.
Yes.
As you can see, it's a very beautiful day here in Toronto.
Kind of scary, actually. We've already been splashed and like couldn't see for a good 3 seconds.
Yeah, so follow along with us and We'll eventually see you in Disney World, we hope. All right, we have made it across the border. We are now in Buffalo, and it's still raining.
Horribly.
It is 9:49 a.m. We did have a few stops. Sorry, my hair is like falling out of my ponytail and it looks weird. We did make a few stops and we had quite a lengthy time at the border. It is a long weekend here in Canada, so we expected that, and I think we'll still do okay for time. I don't think it threw us too off course, but we'll see. Anything to add?
The drive sucks so far because the visibility has been terrible with the rain, but the car is holding up, but that's not actually useful to anything that we know of thus far.
So. All right, we have made it to our first stop, which is Fredonia, New York. We are in a lovely Denny's parking lot. I'm guessing you can't even see that. Oh, there you go. Yeah, so we're at Denny's.
This one's a very fast charger, actually. We're almost 800 miles an hour, which is really good.
But it's still telling us that it's going to take an hour to charge, so we might get breakfast. It's 10:38 a.m.
Yeah, like bacon and eggs. Yummy.
Yummy. Anything else to add?
It's still raining horribly.
Yes. All right. So we are slowly wrapping up our charge. We had delicious Denny's for breakfast.
We had light though. We didn't do like the grand Denny's, whatever. We just did regular kind of, they actually have a cool, like pick your choice slam. So you pay $2 for each thing you add or something. We just got a standard kind of like eggs, toast, bacon sort of bread. The hash browns, delicious.
Yeah.
And mix them in the yolk stuff of the sunny side up eggs. But anyways, update for our trip. So one thing we're seeing right now, for one, the weird thing is this stop wanted us to charge to 100%.
Which is very rare.
Yeah. Or it's going to, it says 5 minutes left at 98%, but I normally know that this part, this can normally take 20 minutes, so maybe it's 99% or something. But the interesting thing we're noticing time-wise, we're going to drive for roughly 2.5 hours to the next stop. previously in the winter time, I don't think we were really able to do about a 2.5 hour leg just because, you know, the car couldn't do with the cold air. It was battling trying to heat itself. So it looks like, even though it's not actually super warm, but even
it's
though
only
it's
15
warmer,
degrees Celsius,
it does appear that we are going to get more range for that, which is nice.
And we will confirm that on the next stop. So it's saying we have 5 minutes remaining to continue our trip. We're at 99% battery. So 5 minutes is just to top it off to 100. And we should have 16% by the time we arrive at our next charger, which is in Cranberry Township, Pennsylvania.
It's also pretty cool that we'll get there by 2 o'clock. Like, we'll already be in Pennsylvania today. So I think we're making good time. It looks like we might stop somewhere between West Virginia and North Carolina. Maybe try to get to North Carolina, but we're not going to make South Carolina.
I'd love to get to Charlotte. That would be ideal because I think that's at the end of North Carolina, and then that'll give us a good tomorrow.
We might have to, one of us might have to nap in the car.
Go for it. I'm driving now.
Well, we might not live that.
Shocked. I am shocked. Alrighty, we are here at Franklin Park, Pennsylvania. We got to the charger with the exact percentage. Actually, I think we got here with 17, and I think it called for 16% left. We got here right around 1:55. It's currently 2:08. We went inside and just poked around. We're actually at a Sheetz again. If you remember from our last road trip video, we very much like Sheetz is fun.
We do. It is quite honestly one of the most remarkable stops, gas station, whatever it might be. It seems actually for locals, this is almost like a mini grocery store.
Yeah, it's really cool. I like this place a lot.
It has like to-go foods. We actually found something really interesting, and maybe it's just because we're Canadian, but they do Jack Links. They do a pepperoni stick with cheese, and they have this little like Italian section with all like prosciutto wrapped cheese.
It was awesome.
Or cheese wrapped with prosciutto. I'm a little tired, sorry.
It was like a cheese string though, but wrapped in prosciutto, and it was awesome. Yeah.
So we love, when we saw that this is where we were stopping, we were like, yay.
I'm very excited. We love the Sheetz. Yeah. We are here in beautiful West Virginia.
West Virginia. That's a mouthful, huh? 10 times fast.
And we're out of Sheetz.
Go figure.
I love this place.
And by the way, we decided to get some of this. We are going to try it. So it's pepperoni wrapping mozzarella. And I totally said that in reverse. So grammatically, that's
mozzarella. Wrapped with pepperoni. So this charge is supposed to take about 40 minutes total. We have 30 minutes remaining of that. So we went in, just bought some snackies and did all that stuff. Where are we? The next stop is about 3 hours from here. And then the next stop is at 10:47 p.m. And that's where we're hoping to stop overnight. That would be right around Charlotte, North Carolina. If we could make it there, that would be ideal, I think.
Yeah. We're going to really try to push hard. The real kind of blocker to it is it's literally been raining the whole trip. And down here, the spray from cars, the visibility is really bad. And so when it gets dark, if it's kind of like that, and it'll probably be too dangerous, so we'll probably have to just park it before. But the car has actually been holding. We've been almost doing 3 hour stretches now. That last stretch was about 2 hours and 45 minutes or something, so it's very clear that the battery functions significantly better in the summer.
We're
getting a lot further, so that's really good.
It's not even summer, it's like it's spring, and it's
above
now
zero.
17 degrees, but we started out the trip and at one point it was like only 11 degrees, so it was still quite chilly. So I think as long as it's above zero, you're getting better battery out of the Tesla.
Yeah, but we will keep you posted still, and we'll see if any hiccups. Other than that, the car has actually functioned quite well. We had a couple lane avoidance, yeah, like things. We almost got into an accident. Well, our car almost just pulled
not
into us.
My fault. Yeah. It was the person in the car next to us that it was in one of those heavy mist spray kind of situations, and they totally just came right into my lane and completely freaked me out. Gave me a really bad headache after that too, I think, because I got like really anxious and stressed. But it was all good. Nothing happened. We're fine. The other person is fine. So
yeah.
Yeah. We're just going to keep on tracking.
We'll keep you posted.
And eat our pepperoni mozzarella.
We'll tell you how it is.
This ride is so beautiful. We're surrounded by mountains and valleys and curvy roads.
Super fun to drive.
It's our first glimpse of the sun on this drive. Look at that. It's beautiful.
Poking through a little.
Where even are we right now? We're in the clouds. Guess where we are?
If you haven't been paying attention, I don't think we need to tell you again. Our third one. This one was really, so here, this is really interesting, in fact. So if you want to talk about kind of what a food disparity, I guess, or choices. So we got two hot dogs for, where's the receipt? $2.98. You can get a little tiny cookie in there for $2.20. We decided every time we're going to get two hot dogs. And you could actually load these with so much stuff. I remember last time we did this, and man, were we dirty after.
It's true. So technically right now we are at an unplanned previously stop because Mr. Speed Demon over here.
That's not true. We were on a phone call actually, and our GPS couldn't talk, I guess, because it was using the sound system for the phone call. And so we literally up here, like, stops are very few and far in between, and we're going through the mountains, and we just missed our turnoff, so we actually had to drive 6 miles and then
one way
and miles
then, yeah,
back, because there's nowhere to turn around. You can't just like pull over and loop around. There's like mountains and then a big moat in the middle.
So we're here still in West Virginia. Now we are still going ahead. We have a stop planned in Wytheville, Virginia at 9:08 p.m. And then the next stop after that is Fort Mill, South Carolina at 11:48. And I think we're going to try to push through and get there and maybe stop overnight in Rock Hill. That was our original plan. It's a lot later than we had originally planned to stop. So we'll see how tired we are, but we're hoping that we can
maybe
make
an hour, actually. I think originally it was supposed to be 10:45, and yeah, we'll probably get there for an hour and a half, like 12:15-ish. But yeah, we just need a hot beef injection quickly. And then we'll be ready to get going.
Catch you on the next one. Hold your breath. Hello.
Hello.
From Virginia.
Yes.
Virginia is for lovers.
Are we staying here tonight, though?
No.
No.
We are. Where are we?
Wytheville.
Yep.
Wyattville?
What? Something like that?
I can't even see. Like, yeah, we're somewhere.
Somewhere in Virginia. Right around Interstate 81 and 77, where they kind of come together.
the hot dogs gave us the power to keep going, so we're gonna keep going. It's 9:30. We're gonna try to our next stop, maybe we'll get there for 11:53, and then we might actually go a little further to get a little more into South Carolina.
Our original plan was to stop in Rock Hill, which is, it seems like it's a suburb of Charlotte. We don't super know, we're not super familiar with the areas, but lots of people recommended stopping in Rock Hill.
Yeah. So we'll find out in probably, what, 3 hours?
We went through some cool mountains. That was fun.
And yeah, like our last leg, the really fun part was the tunnels in the mountains.
Yeah.
There was two of them, and like they're just really long stretches, and they seem very like things you would see in a European movie or something. Lots of fun though. But yeah, there was nothing else super eventful. It was because of the twists and turns, it was actually a lot of traffic, and so it, like, we really had to pay attention because yeah, you could easily fuck yourself up there. Like, fall off a cliff or something.
Thankfully we didn't. Yay. Yeah.
We're maybe a little tired, but
yeah, I'm getting tired. I have a headache.
She's had one all day.
Yeah.
It's because she has to sit with me, though.
Also, what is up with toll roads and no people inside manning the booths and no credit cards? This was the most eventful part of the last leg of our trip. We needed 75 cents. We had 50 cents. I had to run across to the toll booth that had a person in it. And the only person that was in a toll booth was in the Easy Pass lane. What?
And we tried to like flag down someone like holding up money to show them we just need change, and they literally like they gave us like the polite finger, so they're like, and just drove away with, didn't even open their window or anything, like it's fine if you don't have change, but
it was funny.
Yeah.
Next time we will come prepared with rolls of quarters though, or with an Easy Pass toll. Like, we knew that we were supposed to order one before we went. We were just lazy about it, and then it got too late, so we didn't have one. But we'll try to get one for the way back, because I think that'll make things a lot easier.
Yeah, I agree. But we're just going to chill a bit. Probably snack, actually. We haven't actually had a proper meal. We had a hot dog.
Hot dog.
Yummy.
Well, we had Denny's this morning, too.
Oh, I lied. I'm a filthy liar. But yeah, we had that Denny's, which actually most likely held us down for, like, there's a lot of calories and energy, and, you know, I'm got to keep this fed a little, so. But yeah.
Yeah, we're getting silly now, so.
Peace out.
7 a.m. update. We are getting ready to leave the hotel. We are looking at the map here, and if all goes well, we're gonna get to Disney World around 4:20 p.m.
Which means we were able to knock out this trip in roughly a day and, I guess, two-thirds.
The funny thing is, we based this trip based on last trip, so we don't actually have a hotel for tonight, and we're gonna wing it, and we're gonna try and get to All-Star Movies for the night before we actually get to our proper vacation booked stuff.
Yes.
Yes.
I've never stayed there, and
I've never stayed there either, actually. I've stayed at All-Star Sports before.
And in the grand scheme of Disney hotels, it's priced really awesome, and
there's a 30% discount right now.
Annual pass.
For annual pass holders, yeah. Which we are. Yay!
Yeah, so we're gonna, I think we're just gonna check it out. Plus, it's on the Skyliner. It's a Sunday, so I don't think it'll be too super busy. And because we're annual pass, like, we didn't have any park stuff for tonight, but it looks like if we get there for 4, we can go see fireworks and have a few drinks somewhere.
Or maybe we'll just go to the Polynesian and
hang out.
Yeah, we'll play it by
dirty ear. Polynesian night.
Hello from Case, South Carolina, which is exit 1, right before we get into Georgia. So we're stopped here. We have about 20 minutes remaining to continue our trip, and we've got
parties.
This is a sausage breakfast sandwich on a biscuit. I haven't bitten into it yet. Let's see what we got here. Well,
it's a biscuit.
It's a biscuit.
So
it's really salty.
I'm not the most well-versed in Southern food. But yeah, right away, there's a lot of butter and salt right on the outside of the biscuit. I imagine probably butter on biscuits would be good.
It's also just like all the biscuits that I've had. Ooh, there's someone with a WBW bumper sticker that just pulled over there. All the biscuits that I've had have had a little bit more crunch to them. This is just really soft and, I don't know, sort of underwhelming. The coffee is not awful. My favorite. Yeah, okay, awful. Yeah. So all in all, probably would not stop at Hardee's again.
No, it'll facilitate the massive calories we need to just sit in the car for 8 hours and sustain energy. But yeah, like this would not be a go-to for me. Mm-hmm. This is just, you know, convenience right now. So
yep.
Well, we tried Hardee's. Sorry, Hardee's. Have a good day.
This is the first time I've gotten to wear my sunglasses on this whole drive. We finally have a tiny little peak of blue skies up ahead.
In 30 hours, the only blue we've seen.
We are in Georgia, about 83 miles or so from Savannah, I think.
Woo!
This is what it looks like driving in some of this craziness. Like,
this sucks.
There's a car there in front of us. Like right there. But you can barely see it.
And he has his lights on too.
Yeah. Wow. People are like grinding past it.
Howdy from Pooler, Georgia.
So we made a mistake before. We weren't in Georgia. We thought we were.
We totally drove for a long time. We passed a mile marker sign that had like the 1 mile marker. And then the next mile marker that we saw was like 200 and something. And we didn't notice any welcome to Georgia sign, but we just assumed we were in Georgia. And I don't think we were. I don't know why the mile markers changed though, because we didn't flip highways or anything, I don't think. But anyway.
It was raining.
It was bad. I did not enjoy driving in that. It's let up now, so we should hopefully have a nice clear drive. We go from Pooler, Georgia to Kingsland, Georgia to charge. And then our next charging stop should be Daytona Beach, Florida. And then on to All-Star Movies Resort.
Last minute, little change of plans we did.
Yeah. Excited.
We're really excited. Extremely discounted too.
I'm also really excited because here in whatever stop we're at in Georgia, they had chewy ice.
Ooh.
It's my favorite kind of ice.
Yes. She loves ice.
Checking in from Kingsland, Georgia.
Yay!
We have sun.
I actually can't even really see the camera too well because it's so sunny, but it is beautiful. It's 33 degrees.
Yep.
It's actually jumped up about 10 degrees in the last
half hour or so.
Well, in the last like 50 miles, like it would literally almost every few minutes just go up one more degree.
Yep.
So, ooh, look at this beautiful. Oh. Show this Tesla. Look at that. Look at the hue on that.
Gorgeous.
Ooh. Okay. But yes, the trip is going great. I believe we're gone from the rain, so we're all good.
I think we are 3 miles from Florida right now. So this is our last.
Yeah,
we're at exit 3 on the highway.
We go to Daytona Beach.
Yeah, so our next stop is Daytona Beach, and then our next stop after that is Disney World.
Yay.
Woohoo!
Welcome to sunny Florida.
We've made it to our last charge spot.
And we only had to sit here for 5 minutes.
Yeah, it's already ready to go, and we have 34% battery.
Listen, it's yelling at us.
We're going to boost it up a little bit more so that we're driving in with more than 10% battery to Disney World so that we can take it a little easier after we get there. We don't have to find a charge spot right away. But we are in Deltona, Florida, and the last part of the drive was pretty good. And we are.
I napped a little.
Excited.
Yeah. I'm super tired now.
Yeah, I'm kind of tired too.
So, you know, like the drive was really fun, but at the same time, I'm kind of happy it's about to be over because, like,
this is the best part of the trip now.
Well, like Georgia and Florida, they're kind of boring. They're just flat, and yes, the trees and whatnot on the highway are kind of nicer, but overall, it's not much to see, and at least in my opinion. And I'm sorry if I offend anyone.
No, it's just really fun driving through like West Virginia and like all the curves and the mountains. Like that, there it's exciting to drive. Here, the only reason it's really exciting is because you're so close to your destination, I think.
Yeah. But yeah, we're going to have fun soon. Make sure you stay tuned. We'll probably put together. We're actually, because we added this All Stars tonight. We're probably going to have reviews of many hotels where we decided to break this apart and try different levels of hotels because they were offering really good discounts for this time of the year because it's not too busy at Disney. So they're giving like 30 or 40% off rooms. So we decided to jump around a little. We were able to get Animal Kingdom for like 60% off.
I'm really excited about that one.
Yeah, really excited. But we'll stay tuned and we'll keep you posted.
Hello from Disney World.
I'm wearing a different shirt, fine.
We did shower. We feel much more refreshed. You couldn't tell from my hair because I didn't wash it. So I'm washing it tomorrow morning. Don't worry. It's okay.
I'm not going to sleep beside her.
Uh-oh.
I will, of course. Doesn't matter.
Anyway, thank you so much for watching our road trip.
Hey, and by the way, it's not raining and we have sun. It was raining when we left here maybe 20 minutes ago, but yeah.
Make sure you stay tuned. We will have lots of great content, including our review of the All-Star movies,
which we are standing in right now.
Woohoo!
Have a good night.
Good night.